Tens of thousands of people from around the world are paying their respects to former Pope Benedict XVI this morning, visiting his body as it lies in state. Let's go live to Europe correspondent Kari Ann Greenbank, who is at the Vatican for us this morning. Kari, what's the turnout been like there?
Good morning, Charles. Well, we've just heard the latest figures, actually, and since 9 o'clock this morning when the lying in state started, the Vatican says 65,000 people have streamed through St Peter's Basilica to view the body of Pope Benedict and pay their respects. That's an extraordinary figure when you think about it, particularly given that police earlier this morning were saying they were only expecting around 25,000 people today, and this is the first of 3 days of this lying in state. But what we saw here was crowds are snaking right around St Peter's Square behind me, people waiting many hours to get inside. We were granted media access inside the Basilica, and inside there was a mood of quiet reflection, sombre contemplation. There were people who had clasped their hands in prayer. There were kids on their parents' shoulders trying to see over the crowd. There were a lot of people taking photos, a lot of people taking videos, trying to remember this moment. It felt like a mix between the faithful paying homage to the Pope and tourists who were really interested in just being a part of what essentially is a moment in history. Now, this lying in state runs for another 2 days. On Thursday, the funeral mass will be held right here at St Peter's Square. Pope Francis will be presiding over that funeral mass, and that will be historic in itself because it will be the first time a pope has been buried by his successor, Charles.
Kari, thank you.